Hello, everybody. Keller Williams Agents and our wonderful guests. Welcome back to our Bold Pivot Niblets. This is Niblet number 11. My gosh, it's going to be pretty soon. We're going to get through the whole ear of corn here. That's what niblets are, right? They're this, yeah, okay. All right, there's my joke. Anyway, Molly DeMatos and Denny Grimes coming to you here from Asheville, North Carolina and Naples, Florida. We are here to bring you these wonderful niblets. Niblet number 11 is going to be run by the amazing Coach Denny Grimes. Coach Denny, take it away.
Get out your pen, pencil, lipstick, mascara. I want you to write down three questions that are must-ask questions for buyers or sellers. And here's number one. I call it the meat thermometer. Listen, if you were having a huge party, Molly, and somebody were to call you and say, listen, I can't find your house. Where are you? What might be one of your first questions you would ask them?
Where are you right now?
There you go. So when you meet with a buyer or seller and you start having conversations, you want to discover where they are, because you know what the most crowded state in the nation is? It's called the state of denial. And there's no right or wrong. However, we have to understand how to help them. And we do that by asking where they are. Or in the meat thermometer example, we take their temperature. So let me ask you, Molly, you're now working with me as a buyer. Maybe we're on the phone. Maybe we're at a Starbucks. Let me ask you a question, Molly, based on your opinion of the market. You're a buyer coming into Naples. And there's, hey, by the way, there's no right or wrong answer here. Do you feel the market's working in your favor or working against you?
I'm not sure it's working in my favor. I see there's really limited inventory. So it's, I feel like it's probably going to be pretty competitive.
Yes. Well, you know, you're right. Now, you know, here's the thing. No matter what they say, you're right. Because, you know, the bottom line is when they say that, then it gives us the opportunity to agree with them and say, yes, this is called a seller market because there's more sellers than more buyers than sellers. And it means the prices are inching up. So the sooner we act, the better. Wouldn't you agree? So there we go. Now give me the other answer.
No, I think this is going to be super duper in my favor. There's a million houses on the market and everything's amazing.
Now, here's the thing. People want to look good and be right. Now, that's their opinion, right? And so at least we know where we're starting. So we may have some wood to chop to get them into reality. And you would do that by asking, okay, and what leads you to believe that? You would do some digging. Either way, you have a starting point. Now, from a seller standpoint, hey, Molly, based on, you know, I know you're a seller in this market, based on what you see happening in your neighborhood, and there's no right or wrong answer here, do you think the market's working in your favor or working against you?
For sure. I think it's working in my favor. There's nothing else for sale. So my house is it.
And that may seem like an obvious question, you guys. However, the seller might say, hey, well, I think it's working against me. However, I think it's going to turn because you've got election year. You've got all the stuff going on in the economy. So I think getting is good right now. Now, that would be awesome because now you know you have urgency on your side. You're right, Molly. The best thing to do is to sell while the market's still cooking before the market changes based on their theory. So that's called the meat thermometer. You would ask a buyer or seller that anytime early in the conversation so you at least know mentally where they are. This one here, we just kind of role played in a prior niblet. So go back in a couple of niblets and watch as you talk to a seller. And if they want to overprice based on what you suggest the market range is, you're not given prices. Remember, we set expectations. The thing is, Molly wants to set a price. And so on $450,000, going back to the role play that we did, comp show maybe closer to four. And again, if she has motivation, I'm going to take the listing. However, I'm going to set the stage. Molly, all right, so if we have an initial asking price of $450,000, are you prepared to list your home with me today?
Yes.
Awesome. So then I have the commitment. It, by the way, it doesn't do any good to keep answering objections unless you close for a commitment. So, okay, $450,000. Now, am I saying it's going to sell? No. Am I saying it's not going to sell? No. We're neutral because I've seen homes sell higher than I think possible. And I've seen homes that I think were well-priced not sell.
Time out. Slow down. I want everyone to make sure they heard that. Stay neutral. You do not have a crystal ball. Like Denny just said, some homes sell higher, some homes sell lower. We're not perfect. Okay, time in.
Awesome. So again, we've talked about it in prior niblets. As a listing agent or as a buyer's agent, a professional sets expectations. They don't set prices. So Molly had $450,000, and here's what I want you to write down. They said, beautiful question. What do you do? What will you do if the market says no? It's not that it doesn't sell. The market's always speaking. And let me give you a little tip. The market is always right, and it only knows, has two reactions, and it only knows one word. The market knows no. It acts on yes. Any listing out there that has not sold, you lower it down to $10, they will all sell. There is a price that everything sells, and you've got to get it into the right range. So, Molly, what will you do if the market says no?
Well, I guess we'll have to lower the price.
Well, she's being nice. What else would an ornery seller might say?
I'll just wait until till it comes up.
Now, there again, with the rule is if they have motivation, I'll take the listing. If they don't have motivation, that's exactly what they're going to say. I'll just wait here until the market comes to me. Now you're building a set of custom cabinets. You have no earthly idea when or if you'll ever get paid for them. That's called practice. Practice is more fun somewhere else. I learned in my first 10 years of real estate, if your commission check's going to be zero, the sooner you learn about it, the better. So what will you do if the market says no? My last one here, in this little niblet, Molly, is how we get to the center of the Tootsie Roll Pop. They've been teaching in Bold and in sales for the longest time that when somebody raises an objection or concern, you want to acknowledge it. Molly is the master at doing this. She acknowledges with such care and compassion, no judgment whatsoever. The next step is to isolate. And what you want to do is you want to isolate it down before you start addressing it and the way you isolate. So Molly, let me ask you a question. So other than price, is there any, other than commission or fee, is there any other reason you might, that you wouldn't do business with me today? And come up with something.
Well, the price has to be right. We're not just going to sell just to sell.
Okay, y'all watching the niblet. I've got this is like the Jesus wept verse in the scripture. This is an easy one to memorize, right? It's only three words. Well, other than that, Molly, what else would have to happen for you to do business with me today?
So the commissions, we figured that out. The price is right. For us, really, it's about money. So I think that's it.
Okay. Now, again, could they have some other things in this marketplace?
For sure. I got to find a place to buy. I've got to make sure I'm not going to move here. I got to make sure that I've got to interview four other agents. I've got to check with the person who actually owns the house. We hear it all, right, Denny?
And here's the thing. What I want you to do is be patient. Hold, like in the movie Gladiator. Hold, wait. Other than that, Molly, okay. I'm making notes. I want to understand. And you can say something different. Like, okay, I've got that. What else? Go, go, go until they cry uncle. You get it all on the table. Because if you don't, you're playing whack-a-mole for the rest of the transaction because you got all these little things popping up that you never discussed. Yep. So memorize, other than that, and write down, get to the center of the Tootsie Roll Pop. And then, last question you would ask, Molly, of the 85 things you just listed, which one is most important to you right now?
Price.
There you go. If you go circle back around after they say three or four different things and ask them what's really the most important thing to you right now, many, many, many times they will make it the one issue for them. And you know what? It might surprise you. So ask the question.
Indeed.
There you go, Molly.
Fantastic. I trust everyone's going to rewind this and write everything down. Even if you didn't, remember, first you make the choice and then the choice makes you. So level up. Start this back over, get your pens out, and these are the things that you practice, practice, practice. These niblets all put together are going to get you an earful. So right. Enjoy yourselves.
And I hope you don't think we're corny.
Ba-dum.
Next niblet.
Bye, y'all.